My name is Max. Yep, that's still the story I'm sticking to. I hope I've been keeping you entertained tonight. But if maybe you're thirsty for some more guys to get into the action, now's your time to lay back and enjoy things even more. Now, just between us men.
Chemsex, I mean, this is something, I don't know if it's still happening. I was part of the whole Chemsex scene.
Yes, it's still happening.
I come from the days, I didn't even know how I got involved in it. I got involved with lines and sex and then eventually taking Viagra because you lose your hard on while you're on Chems. And then you take Viagra to kind of have your heart on going, and then you end up kind of
but
going.
Doesn't that depend what chems you're on, though?
Yeah, exactly. Because the chems that I took doesn't make my heart on go away.
I don't know. Stuff like cat crystal meth does kind of lose to
okay,
you.
Okay, well, I've never done crystal meth, but I've done cat before.
And you get you have a hard on cat.
Yeah, of course. Especially
when you're horny.
Exactly.
Yeah, but the problem was for me, how I experienced this, is that you kind of battle to keep it up, and then you take Viagra to keep it day.
No, I've also heard that story, and it works a different way with me, because once it's up, you struggle to get it down again. Down, boy.
Yeah,
down,
no, boy. I agree with that one. My experience was more with ecstasy back in the day when we were clubbing, and you would go there to go clubbing, and then for 9 hours you would spend in the dark rooms, mm-hmm. because ecstasy, you love everybody. So it ended up being big group orgies in the dark rooms. And that's where you would sit for 9 hours because it just didn't go down. Because you love everybody, hard for 9 hours, and you end up playing with everybody you can get your hands on.
Literally. Well, the first time that I used cat, well, actually I was afraid to use it because of previous experiences and personal experiences. And then my boyfriend said, okay, let's do it, but we are at home. So I tried it and nothing happened the first time, and the second line went, and all of a sudden we started touching and feeling and fraying and going on. And when I wiped my eyes out, it was 11 hours later and 17 times that I ejaculated, and it was the best time of my life.
One of the things, yeah, that's interesting to me, number one, is don't you think that it can become an addiction, that you need the chemical to have sex?
No. It makes it more fun, yes. And if it's in the roundabout, I won't say no. But I don't feel like I need it to have good sex.
Is there a difference? For me, there was.
There is a difference, yes, but...
Well, sensations are definitely heightened. I mean, you feel everything 10 times more than what you would if you weren't on chems. But I'd have to agree, it's not a case of you have to do chems to have sex. I mean, you get horny without doing chems.
Exactly. You get horny without even watching porn. So
for me, I think the whole thing is that happened as well. It's these walls came down when you're on chems. I think you normally wouldn't do
that. No, use your inhibitions.
Absolutely. I mean, you do stuff that you would never dream of doing. You become your own porn star when you're on this stuff.
Yeah, if you have the porn body, I guess.
Not even. I don't
know, because you don't care what your body looks like. You just go for it.
Oh, that's also true.
Well, you have to start recklessness. Don't you become reckless on those things? I'm always a control freak, so for me, I've never. But doesn't it reach a point where it becomes a bit reckless where you just don't care?
Luckily, in every time that I've used cat and had sex, it was in a safe environment where people... where it was just me and my boyfriend, or me and my fuck buddy, or whatever the case may be. So it wasn't like we were going out and making a hell of a thing about it. Pardon the pun.
Well, that's why I'm actually glad I'm not doing Chemsex anymore, because it got to a point where you know what you're doing, you just don't actually care. So if there was condoms, there was condoms. If there weren't condoms, there weren't condoms.
Okay, well, luckily with me, I just bareback my boyfriend. And every time it was with my boyfriend, except for the few times that it was with a fuck buddy, but that was a regular fuck buddy.
But it still wasn't in a safe environment. Like I've never did it in clubs. The only times that I experimented,
I've taken cat in clubs, but I didn't go that extra mile.
But I think the other thing with chemsex as well that happens is that, you know, you kind of get obsessed with what you're doing at the time, isn't it, as well? Mm-hmm. I found
it's
me.
It's the only thing you focus on.
Yeah. And that is why your hard-on stays without Viagra.
But there's something wrong with me here. I clearly haven't had the same experiences.
Well, I've heard a lot of stories of people that also didn't have the same experience, so I don't think I'm using it right then. I don't know.
Yeah, I do know. What happens as well, in my case, what totally happens is I take Kim's and I become a bottomless, kind of endless bottom pit. Not that I'm normally a bottom. But when Chemsex is involved, for some reason, I think there's an alter ego that comes out with me and I become like this total passive bottomless and I just don't care. I don't know, as long as I'm satisfied.
Exactly. And the hours are still going, so why not? If not, why not? Then we make turns. Then I don't care if I'm a top or a bottom.
You just do it because you can.
Yeah, and it's fun.
Just want more.
And it's everlasting. Everlasting. Never-ending story.
Well, if it's 17 times that you ejaculate it, then it is everlasting. I mean, oh gosh, I don't think I've even managed.